Hey, what's going on? It's your boy BT, and I came here to talk some boxing with the thousands of True School Sports subscribers now, where it's my brethren in Chi-Town, Chicago. Shout out to Chicago. And speaking of Chicago, we're going to talk about Chicago's very own Adrian Granados. Okay, it's been a while since I've actually had a chance to make any, like, there really hasn't been any Adrian Granados news out there because, truth be told, I know Adrian pretty well. We usually speak every couple days. He's probably the fighter I'm closest to in boxing. We're pretty cool. Adrian has been MIA for a long time. Like, you can't even, you like legit, you it's been damn near impossible for like the last, from pretty much after the Porter fight, so from basically to December, from December to April, he was pretty much MIA, like missing in action. His phone was off, wasn't on social media, he was inactive. I often wonder, like, what the hell is going on with Adrian Granados? You know, did the guy get into trouble in Chicago? Did Adrian, you know, like, is he gonna retire from boxing? Are they setting him up to lose a fight? Like, all kinds of stuff went through my mind with Adrian, but then eventually I got a hold of him. But we'll get into that later in the video. The point of the video, as you guys can see by the title, is Adrian recently posted a picture on what he's been up to since the Sean Porter fight, where he took a loss in that fight. He had some moments here and there, but really for the first time in his entire career, you know, his career has been littered with all kinds of controversial decisions that have not gone in his favor. You know, he seems to be one of those fighters that has gotten the short end of the stick, pretty much every big fight he's had, you know, with like guys like Broner and Kermit Cintron and guys like that. But people know he's a quality fighter, especially at 140 pounds. And after the Porter fight, he went MIA, and he made a post recently that and it said the following. He said, I quote, "In case y'all were wondering where I've been or what I've been doing, I'm working with my idol. They are the reason I always wanted to be a boxer. It's an honor to be here." And then the picture is of him in the gym with boxing legend and arguably the greatest Mexican fighter who ever lived, in Julio Cesar Chavez. So Adrian Granados is working with Julio Cesar Chavez. That was that came from left field, honestly. Yeah, he told me this 3 weeks ago before he posted this on Instagram. He actually sent me this picture that's in my thumbnail 3 weeks ago before he actually posted it on Instagram. And he's in Mexico and he's been getting in work, and he's told me, you know, some stuff that he has some a fight lined up on the horizon. So once that actually gets announced, I'll talk about it. But I mean, it's great news, man. Obviously, in his day, you know, Julio Cesar Chavez, he fought in a style where, you know, he liked to pressure you. He liked to fight on the inside. And obviously, that's what Adrian Granados, when he's at his best, that's what he does really, really well. I think, and I told Adrian this too, because I've been very upfront with Adrian about what I feel he does wrong, what I feel he could do better. And you know, credit to Adrian. Before I could even tell him most of these things, he's already in the gym correcting him. So that shows awareness on his part. That shows that he's being real with himself. And that shows a hunger that he still, that he actually wants to be at the best fighter he can be. And I stand by what I said after the Porter fight and after the Broner fight, after he took two losses last year. You know, he took a very controversial loss in the Broner fight. You know, a lot of people thought he won that fight. I mean, just this week, even in the Vargas fight, right? Adrian Broner fought Jesse Vargas this past weekend. They were saying on the telecast that Granados should have beat Broner, that he should have got the decision over Broner. And truth be told, I thought he looked better than Vargas did against Broner, all things considered. You know, Vargas got a 12-round fight. Granados didn't. Vargas didn't have to deal with fighting in Broner's hometown. Granados did. So, you know, even in all that, I think Granados had just as good a performance as Vargas, if not better. And, yeah, man, I'm happy to see what happens in his career. You know, obviously, with the 140-pound division right now, Terrence Crawford moved up to 147 after getting all the belts. So that division is wide open. You know, you got the likes of Regis Prograis and Jose Ramirez and a whole host of fighters in that division that he can have big fights with. And I think he can beat a lot of those guys. I stand by it. And, you know, he's made correction. He's been going by himself, making the corrections in the gym in Mexico with Julio Cesar Chavez. And I'm actually gonna show you guys. I asked him if I could do this before I just decided to make the video. So he gave me the okay. I'm actually gonna show you some of what he told me when we first talked for the first time in like 4 months the other day. So here it is.
Yeah, so basically, as you guys can see on the screen, basically the way I got a hold of Adrian is on March 30th at approximately 5:32. I hit him up and I basically just told him, just giving him my thoughts on the Porter fight, and I said, the following, as you guys can see, I said, "Hey, bro, I had a chance to finally watch the TV version of your fight with Sean Porter for the first time. I didn't score, but I thought I would just give you my take on some stuff. I thought you did better than I gave you credit for when I watched you from the nosebleeds. Especially early on. I thought your jab was working well and you were able to find the range with your right hand, and he even showed some good defense early in the fight. As the fight wore on, though, I think Porter began to figure you out because you have this habit where you get out of range to take a breather, and once you get in range, you always attack in a straight line. So he's just waiting for you to commit so he knows when to throw a punch. I think it was the ninth round where Porter literally just sat in the middle of the ring waiting for you to come in a straight line, and he countered you with some stuff. You gave a good account of yourself on that night, and a more refined version of you can actually beat Sean Porter. It looks like to me when you're in your stance that you have more weight on your front foot, so when you actually attack your opponent, it causes you to lunge. I feel like if the weight was distributed better between both feet, it would be even more effective. Also, when you get into a stance, you leave your chin in the air, and it showed when Porter got you on the ropes. You have the tools to be a world champ, but you have to clean those things up. I think with your movement and jab, you could actually refine your style a bit and become more of a mover. You have to actually trust and believe in your jab. You have to even work on doubling and tripling up on your jab because that will allow you to get on the inside easier and set up your right hand. Also, maybe even use your hips a bit more so you can turn your opponents and rip left hooks to their bodies as well as create some openings when you're inside. These are just a few things I saw in the fight. I thought I would share with you. Hope we can talk soon, bro. God bless, whatnot. Right? So I told him that, and then the irony of everything was like I was at the Marlins game, and they're playing the Chicago Cubs, and Adrian Granados from Chicago, so he said he's a massive Cubs fan. I'm a massive Marlins fan, so that pretty much opened up the door for conversation. And basically, as you guys can see, he tells me that I'm a step ahead. He's a step ahead of me on those corrections. That's why he's been, missing in action. He had to hit the reset button. He's been in Jedi boxing training, So then I said, whatever it takes, man, I understand. I remember we briefly talked about this before the Porter fight. You're not being much on social media as much. And it's funny too because I hung out with Adrian the night before the Porter Granados weigh-in, right? That's when I went to his hotel room when I did the interview with him. And we actually, it was funny, we actually wound up going to the gym that day. I actually like we did like light workouts in the gym. And I remember we had a talk about like just because he's on social media all the time. Like he pretty much just told me like about how he's got to discipline himself more with that. So it finally happened, and as you guys can see, it says yes. This time I went all out to hit the reset button. I actually left the States, and then I said I respect it, bro. And he said I'm in the motherland. Really? For how long? Mexico? He's like, yep, I've been here for 4 months. And I said, yo, that's great. How are you feeling about whatever changes you made? And then he said, great. It's been a blessing. Making this decision, good mesh with my family and my team, and also power moves might be forming on the business side as well. And then I said, well, I look forward to seeing what comes of it. You sound like you're on some Bruce Lee stuff. And then he basically just said negotiations are going on right now for a fight, blah 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 blah. And I told him, I also said, I told him, I said straight up, I said, I thought that because of his silence that they were setting up for Keith Thurman, and his response was, yeah, screw these boxing mobsters, screw with me, I'm done with that. Now I'm gonna have someone backing me up for once. Now, and then I said, I agree, bro. You're a talented fighter who has never been looked after. It's about time you do boxing. The boxing game needs you. And then he said, this is strictly a BTAG confidential. About to send you a pick of what I've been on. And then then he sent me the pick of Julio Cesar Chavez, and that's when I found out. So I found out on March 30th about this, and way before he posted it. And then he got into more of like just what he's been going through in that gym. Apparently, he said, I asked him what's that been like, and he said surreal. It's actually his brother Rodolfo who's been training me, and then when Julio is in town, he gives me tips and takes me around. And then I said, bro, I'm sorry for you. And then he said, I'm training in Junior's gym. I've met Omar. I'm like their new dog. They keep sending me new sparrings though, and I keep tearing them up. They're refining my skills, not making too many changes, just subtle ones. I needed. I knew I wasn't fighting the way I should. Sloppy, hands down, a lot of chin up, just relying on my natural skills. No basics, and that's what I've basically gotten back to, the basics. And then Yeah, and then he's then he basically gets into himself. He's like, he says, "I didn't like my performance against Porter. I know I should have beat him, but I didn't do what I should have." And that's pretty much it, man. So yeah, he's been in Julio Cesar Chavez Jr.'s gym, working with their family. You know, obviously, he's been getting some tips and advice and guidance from the great Julio Cesar Chavez himself. But also, he's been sparring with Omar Chavez, who is a prospect in himself, and he's someone that I know people are relatively high on. So it's good that to hear that Adrian has just kind of got away from boxing, because I mean, he's a fun fighter to watch, and you know, the subtle changes that he's been making, supposedly, you know, that's going to be, if he ever wants to get to a level, because you know, he's still relatively young, you know. Sparring with a guy like Omar Chavez. Omar Chavez, you know, still young himself, 36-4-1. You know, not a world champion or anything like that like that, but a good domestic level Mexican fighter who's still young. So he's been getting good work in there with him, with a guy that, in terms of dimensions, like as far as his height and reach, is very similar to Adrian. So it's not a bad thing to get work in someplace you're comfortable, someplace that pushes you, someplace where you got a guy like Julio Cesar Chavez to go to for advice. And but yeah, the subtle changes he needs to make as far as, like, you know, his posture in the ring, his stance, his balance, his chin, things like that. Those are the things that are going to take Adrian Granados from a guy that's a fringe level contender who can upset, you know, someone on any given night, to a guy that is a world champion and someone that's to be reckoned with in boxing, you know. So hopefully, just for his sake, I hope he continues making those changes. I look forward to hearing when his next fight's going to happen. And we'll be following Adrian Granados as it goes on, because honestly, he's one of the better people. He's one of the best people I've met in boxing. And on top of that, he just happens to be a good fighter, a very good fighter in his own right, and someone that you know, has taken on all comers. And you know, hopefully now, as he told me in our conversation, hopefully, you know, he can be looked after a little more, as a lot of other fighters are, because he has a lot of qualities that I feel like, if you were a promoter, you should be jumping to sign this guy. In fact, if I was someone like an Eddie Hearn, right? If I was Eddie Hearn and I was looking to grow my Matchroom USA stable, Adrian Granados would actually be someone that I would look into and put my money behind, because he's obviously a Mexican fighter. He's young. He's got a good personality. He's got a fan.